you know, what was needs at one point in time is today the bare minimum to start, and it's no more a need. We are trying to redefine Maslow's pyramid totally.
Aspirations are also.
So that has made it very important for us to redefine talent management. So maybe talent management today is not you know, something that we keep discussing. Possibly it is something that we do to gain a competitive advantage. Is that
yes,
right way?
That's right.
Because today's competition is based on knowledge,
right,
and less on technology.
Yeah, we each individual carries a certain grain of
contribution. The biggest asset as far as the organization is concerned. So in today's top world, if you say the biggest asset for each and every organization, at least for the service sector,
mm-hmm.
is their people. Mm-hmm. So that's how it happens. And if you manage your people well, I think you would become an industry leader.
Right. So we've understood why talent manage is so crucial. Now my question is, how do we manage this talent? So that is where I get this analytics comes in. A lot of play of analytics happens as to how we manage talent, how this talent management, the whole scenario of talent management is grappled with. Because as I get to read, and as most of us would have read, Albert Einstein has said that all that we count actually may not count, and all that we count actually may not be counted. So, you know, this counting business is pretty complex. You know, you keep counting something which actually does not count for your business. And what actually you don't count actually may be counting for your business as much as you want. So maybe you need to get your data right, you need to get your information right, and that analytics, you know, whatever you call matrices, the metrics and whatever tools you deploy, that tells us how to manage talent.